Yeah, it's recording now.
So which way are you standing?
I'm just going to stand here.
Facing that way, facing that way. Yeah.
Mike, are you real? Hi folks, hope you're okay today. In the Bible, the Word of God, it says this, Romans chapter 3, in the Word of God it says, therefore by the deeds of the law there shall no flesh be justified in his sight, for by the law is the knowledge of sin. For by the law is the knowledge of sin. But now the righteousness of God without the law is manifest, being witnessed by the law and the prophets. Even the righteousness of God, which is by faith of Jesus Christ, unto all and upon all that believe. For there is no difference. For all have fallen short, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, who God has set forth to be a propitiation through faith in his blood, to declare his righteousness for the remission of sins that are passed through the forbearance of God. Just for argument's sake, what if there is a God? What if there is a God, for argument's sake? How would you know this God? How would you know such a God? Some people would say, you try to do good deeds, that you do good deeds, and that will get you to God. The Bible says, all fall short of the glory of God. That no matter how good we try to be, we will always be guilty. We will always sin. We will always miss the mark. We'll never be perfect. And so therefore we're guilty. And if God was to judge us, then we'd end up going to hell. But God came down in Jesus Christ, and he lived a perfect life. And he lived a perfect life for a reason. Because he had to be perfect, to be the perfect sacrifice for your sin. And that is the only way to heaven. The only way to heaven is that sacrifice. John the Baptist said, behold the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. And when Christ was on that cross, he was the Lamb. And he shed his blood. But as he's shedding his blood, he's dying on behalf of you. He is taking your punishment, your wrath, your judgment. That's why he's on the cross. And the wrath of God smote him. The wrath of God crushed him. And he was crushed for everything that you did wrong. He was crushed for everything that you did wrong. And if you want to be saved from the wrath of God, if you want to be right before God, you have to come to that blood. Without that blood, there is no hope. Without the blood, there is no hope. Without the blood, there is no way. We need that blood to cover us. We need that blood to cleanse us. We need the blood, my friends. The blood is a beautiful thing. The blood is beautiful that the Savior came and died in your place. He died a beautiful sacrifice, so perfect, so holy, that he did no wrong. He did no wrong. He was perfect and holy and pure. And they laughed at him. They whipped him. They whipped his back. They mocked him. They humiliated him. They spat at him. But my friend, he allowed it to happen because he knew he had to die for you on that cross. There was no other way. He had to die for you on that cross. And he was dying on the cross for you. And he was taking your wrath. Any of you laugh at it, mock at it, ignore it, and say, no, it's a waste of time, you're missing this wonderful blessing of salvation. You're missing a beautiful blessing, the blessing of salvation, to be right with God and to know God and to love God, but to be right with Him. The just shall live by faith in Jesus. So come under the blood. Come under the blood of Jesus. Come under the blood of Jesus. Come under the blood of Christ. That blood can save you. That blood can save you from the wrath to come. There is a wrath of God, because God is a holy God. Holy, holy, holy. Lord God Almighty, who is to come. He is a holy God. And as a holy God, He hates sin. He hates lies. He hates anything that's not right. He's pure and holy. And He hates the things that are not pure. He cannot look upon it, for His purity is perfection. He is a holy God, an awesome God, a mighty God, a glorious God. He's so pure and holy. So every time you lie, every time you curse the name of God, every time you do something wrong, His holiness hates it. He hates it. But He has a love, and the love kicks in, because His love came and died for you. And He died taking your wrath. He died, a holy God who knew no sin. He died for you. And He was crushed for you on that cross. He was crushed that you may live. He was crushed beyond belief. Oh, He was crushed. The mighty Savior was crushed on that cross. He bore the full weight of your sin, the full weight of what you did wrong. He bore it on His own shoulders. And there He's in agony. He's in agony with the crown of thorns on His head, nailed to the cross. And He's in agony because He was pure and holy, and yet He had to die for you. He had to die for you. And He died for you. And He died to save you. He died to bring you home so you wouldn't go to hell. He died to save you so you wouldn't go to hell. Don't go to hell. Don't enjoy sin. Don't enjoy lying and stealing and backbiting and hatred. And don't enjoy it, because it'll kill you. The wages of sin is death. The wages of sin is death. It'll kill you. It'll take you to hell. But Christ took your hell. Christ took your hell. He died in your place. Can't you see that? Can't you see He died in your place? He died in your place. Can't you see He died in your place? He died in your place. The Savior, who was perfect and did no wrong, died in your place. Hanging on that cross with a crown of thorns on His head. A beautiful Savior who did no wrong. He did no wrong. He was perfect and holy. And then He died for your sin. He died for what you did wrong. When you lied, when you stole, when you was angry, when you cursed the name of God, He died on that cross for you. He died. So will you believe in Him? Flee to Him. Flee to Him and turn to Him and say, Lord, forgive me. Lord, cleanse me. Lord, have mercy upon me. And plunge beneath Him and humble yourself and say, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. Don't enjoy lying and stealing and immorality. Don't enjoy it, because He put Him on the cross. So how can you enjoy it? Don't enjoy it, but repent of it. Repent, turn around, turn away, and turn to Christ. Hate it, and turn to Jesus. and say, Lord, forgive me. Lord, cleanse me. Lord, have mercy upon me. And come and know His love. Come and know His mercy. Come and know His grace. Come and know His kindness. Come and know His love in your life. Come and know His joy and His peace. Oh, don't go to hell today. Don't do it to yourself. Don't do it to yourself. Don't enjoy lying, stealing, or sleeping around, or pride, or materialism. Don't run away from God. You can't hide from God. He sees what you do. He knows what you do. Come to God. Come to your Father. Come to your God who calls you. Whosoever believe on the Lord shall be saved. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. You can be saved. You might feel you're hopeless, you've no future, but you have a future and a hope if you turn to Jesus.
Amen.
Turn to Him and know His peace and His love in your life. Turn while you can today. Don't go to hell. Don't go to hell, whatever you do. But flee to Him and turn to Him and find love in your life. And the peace of God in your life, and the joy of God in your life. God bless you.
Good, amen. It's good, really good.
Okay. Amen. Put your back. Okay. Yeah. Okay.